Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And it's time for another Dinosaur Dracula Fun Pack unboxing, this one for February 2017.
Feels like we just did one. How do the months go so fast?
Are you ready to dive in this month?
Yeah. This looks like a
skinny, flat box this month.
I know.
What's inside.
It's interesting shape. Let's see. Ooh, food. Tissue paper! What is this? It looks spicy. Mini Takis Fuego. Hot chili pepper and lime tortilla chips.
Well, we gotta give them a try.
Ah!
Look, they're like on fire.
I know!
How hot can they be?
It's scary. You try it. Oh my gosh, look how red they are.
Look how tiny they are.
Look how red they are.
It's just artificial coloring, Ben.
Oh my gosh. Can you talk?
Wow. Try one, Ben.
No.
Try one. They aren't that bad.
Oh, you're such a liar.
They have a kick at the end.
Oh, I got a double. No, I'm not taking a double. Let me get the... Okay. Oh, man. Okay.
Even with the kick at the end, I oddly won another one.
Ugh. Yeah.
Not a fan?
No. Ew. Where's my water? Ew. I don't like those at all.
I didn't think they were that bad.
Ugh.
You want some seconds, Ben?
No. Nope, I'm good. I don't like those. You can keep them. They're all yours.
Well, what about this Twizzler?
That I'll take. Yummy Twizzlers. What's this?
Well, first, look at this.
Okay.
Wacky Ghoulies, Gross Ghoulish Weirdos, 25 cents. I think this is one of those displays, you know, when you're at the exit of Walmart.
Oh!
This is like in the glass vending machine, so you put your quarter in. That's pretty cool. Collect all 8.
Huh. Well, I mean five. I only have 5. Where are the other 3?
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So most of the stuff this month is in this little bubble wrap bag. Let's see what we got. Dump it in there.
What is this? It's like slime with little eyeballs.
It's Experiment 48 PF. Here's a sealed one.
Oh, okay.
Creature status, living. Handle with caution.
Okay. Well, I gotta open it. I have to open it. Okay. Open with caution. Need a little face. Can you guys see that?
The eyeballs aren't actually floating around in the slime. They're in the lid.
Here's one for you.
Ew. It's not as slimy as I thought.
It's a lot thicker. Thicker? Stiffer? I don't really know what the word is.
Of course, you don't know how old it is.
That's true. Does it say on the specimen on how old it is?
No, it doesn't say how old the slime is.
It reminds me of the stuff that Tegan got at the arcade that was like this, but it was a lot more slimy than this.
We got some pink lemonade Kool-Aid to drink.
Ooh.
To wash down those whatever they were called, the spicy chips.
I'm just going to play with this little piece of slime.
We have this cool 8-bit Dino Drac sticker.
Oh, neat. Oh, yeah, look at
that. It's also up here. You didn't even comment on this awesome Ninja Turtle one.
I was thrown off. I saw tissue paper and chips.
So we got some trading cards here. Here are Comics Future Stars, 1993. 9 trading cards. Vote for your favorite. 1993. Okay, let's see. Maybe there were some comics in here that really took off.
Okay, we'll see. I'm super excited for the next pack of cards. Okay.
So here we go. Here are some future comic stars from 1993. Here's Dr. Ptolemy.
Yes.
He has been blessed with immortality, but denied eternal youth.
That's a bummer.
All right, this next guy. This is Big Guns. Lieutenant Major Whitford Brooks, a.k.a. Big Guns, the team leader of the paramilitary group STAT, the Security Through Acquired Talents. All right, I'm going to guess none of these took off.
I don't think so.
Here's Callus.
He looks like Spider-Man with a black head.
He has fought for what appears to be both sides of the law, with the scales of justice weighing towards his own convictions and justifications. All right, how many more of these do we have to
go? All right, let's just do the names of them, okay?
All right.
What do we got?
Unless there's a really interesting one, we're just going to go through them really quick. This is Thunder God.
Like Thor?
He's totally different.
Oh.
Even though he looks like a cross between Thor and...
Aquaman.
All right. This woman looks like she's has floating ice cubes on her hand. This is Zora.
Oh.
This is Cadmus Zark.
Never heard of him.
All the, well, these are like the rookie cards of comic book characters. This is Mortis.
Nope. None of these are ringing any bells.
None of them really took off. This is Vagabond. Nothing?
No. Other than the the song from...
And we have Alpha Zova. So, there you go. I wonder who won the comic Future Stars vote.
None of them.
All right, how about something we have heard of?
Ferngully!
They added the sequel to Netflix. I didn't even know there was a Ferngully 2 until we saw it at a yard sale last year.
Okay. Yay, Ferngully! Okay. X marks the spot. Oh, I can't remember his name.
These were made in 1992, by the way.
Batty.
Robin Williams as a bat.
Mm-hmm. Naughty. Oh, it's a coloring card. There's Naughty and Bark.
Wow, I didn't even remember them from the movie.
Yeah. They were definitely in the movie. I love Ferngully.
We have some more Trash Can Trolls. I know we've got some of these before, also from 92. There we go. These are like, in case you're tuning in late, these are like the troll version of Garbage Pail Kids.
Yeah.
Including Armpit Brit. Ew, his hair is armpit hair.
Ew.
Here's Independence Daisy. That's the one that was on the front of the pack. Here is Stained Blaine. He's a tree and a dog is going pee on him. Here is Jungle Jim, and it's like he's pulling his head back to reveal his brain.
Ew.
Looks kind of like a banana, though.
Yeah, I think that's what they're going
Here is Unkempt Carla, and she has like troll hair coming out of her nose and her ears. And, oh, look at this. It's Phil the Grave. It's like a zombie troll.
Oh, wow. How about something a little bit more pleasant? Pepsi Cola trading cards. Did you know they made Pepsi Cola trading cards?
Nothing surprises me at this point.
I think
everything had its own trading card set in the 90s.
These are from 1994. Okay. Oh, they're sticky.
They're the glossy ones that stick together?
Yep. All right. Ice cold Pepsi. More bounce to the ounce. I don't think I ever remember that being said before.
I'm glad they retired the creepy Pepsi clown.
Yes, definitely. Here are the Pepsi cops. Bigger and better. This is Pepsi and Pete.
You're getting a little Pepsi education.
Yes. And then we have a polar bear.
Oh, wow. Is that where Coke got it?
This is the Pepsi Polar Bear. Pepsi was one of the first soft drink companies to use cup vending machines in theaters and other locations where bottles were not practical. The Pepsi Polar Bear was featured in cup vending machine advertisements.
Interesting.
So who was first?
Who used the polar bear first?
Huh. Well. Oh, and one that we should all recognize. Pepsi Santa.
I thought it was Coke Santa. I guess they just kept copying each other.
This is Santa Jumps for Pepsi. This cardboard cutout was designed for Pepsi by artist Norman Rockwell. Rockwell Santa graced Pepsi Christmas advertisements from the 1960s to the mid-1970s. Pepsi also commissioned a plastic three-dimensional version of this Santa, as well as a cloth banner. So I think Pepsi was first, and then the Coca-Cola.
You think Pepsi was first with Santa and the polar bears?
Well, I don't know. I don't know about the polar bears.
Next up,
we have Big Shot, just two kids drinking some Pepsi. Then we have Pepsi's Best Take No Less. These were different display signs. Ice cold, delicious, ask for it. And we have Get Busy Drink.
They were right to the point in those days.
They were. It says on the back, Pepsi's Purity. This 1908 ad proclaims Pepsi to be the original pure food drink. The Pure Food and Drug Act of 1906 forced many companies to comply with stricter regulation of their ingredients in their products. Pepsi capitalized on the purity of their drink, which required no modification after the passage of the act. So, you heard it here. Pepsi is a pure drink. Safe to drink. It's pure.
At least it was in 1908.
1908.
Well, anyway.
Those are cool. I liked those cards.
Not to be outdone, here's some Coca-Cola Slammers. These aren't official Pogs, but they're Pogs. And let's see, plastic slammers give you the edge when playing the game. Six different slammers randomly inserted at the rate of 1 per 9 packs. You could have a slammer in here. There are 40 caps in the collection from 1995. Do you remember Pogs? I know we've covered Pogs here on Dino Drag before.
I was never a collector, but I do remember Pogs. I never understood what you were supposed to do.
Okay, did we get a slammer?
It doesn't look like it. They all look pretty thin.
Okay, here it is, a Coca-Cola polar bear.
Does it have a date?
Yeah, I said
The polar bear.
So there's a skiing polar bear. Coke. How did this work? Does anybody, maybe there's a YouTuber very passionate about Pogs. It's like a how to do Pogs video.
I think, don't you need the slammer to...
Oh, that's true. We don't have the slammer. Yeah, weren't you supposed to, like, stack them up?
Yeah.
And then, like, throw the slammer down?
Yeah. We don't have a slammer, though.
Oh, look at you. I'm going to do a Bin versus John Pogs video.
I know.
Speaking of Pogs, here's Dino Direct specimen number 31. Matt, we have to say everything flowed nicely into each other.
Yes, very good job, good job.
I'm sure it was intentional.
I'm sure. He put a lot of thought in these.
1994 McDonald's Universal Studios Pogs. Look, brand new and sealed. 1994, two milk cat Pogs and a half-price kids admission coupon to Universal Studios Hollywood.
Do you think that's still good?
Maybe there's no expiration on it.
Maybe. We have a kid. Bring him to Universal Hollywood.
I can't believe we're opening these. Here we go. All right.
First up.
McDonald's is looking out for us. They have the rules right here.
How to play. All right, let me read up on those.
The kids are half price offer is valid October 21st to December 24th, 1994. Now for a limited time only at Universal Studios Hollywood, you can explore Pog World.
Wow, I didn't even know they had a Pog World. So, how to play. Each player stacks an equal number of Pog milk caps face up. That's pretty awesome.
We got an E.T.
That is so cool.
Pog. And we also got... Do you think this is Universal's mascot or the Pog's mascot? I think it was the Pog's mascot.
I don't know. And then you flip a Pog. The first player slams an official hitter at the stack, and all of the Pog caps that land face down go to that player, and all the other ones go for the... You stack them for the next player.
Here's this month's poster. No Dino Drac on it, but it's a nice photo of... Matt's extensive expired food collection.
I saw the post where the, what was it, ravioli?
His Ninja Turtle Chef Boyardee.
Yeah, yeah, it was all rusted out. It looked disgusting. Ew.
We have an essay about vending machine memories.
Oh.
And here we go. Almost time for the art challenge. You ready, Ben?
Ready. All right, what do we have to do?
Well, before we do that, we forgot to mention that Matt says the Wacky Ghoulies vending machine teaser card was from 1986.
Oh.
We were right. They were hung inside vending machines to tempt kids into spending their quarters, drawing inspiration from Madballs toys and the Ghoulies movies. Anyway, this month's art challenge, on the back of this sheet of paper, draw and color dinosaurs in forgotten fashions.
Ooh.
Maybe a T-Rex wearing a hyper-colored shirt, or a Brontosaurus in bell-bottoms trying to figure out slap bracelets. You decide.
Alrighty.
So here we have a Brontosaurus and a T-Rex all dressed up like they're going to a 1950s sock hop. This was all Ben's idea, by the way.
It was, yeah.
I actually think this might be Baby from the movie. Here we have a T-Rex wearing his jeans and his leather jacket and his greased back hair.
Both dinosaurs, they're dancing at the party. So she's wearing a 50s style poodle skirt with the little black and white sneakers. And he's got his Fonzie outfit on. They're so cute! I think they came out really good.
We still have some, Ben. Eat up. Maybe they taste better the second time around.
No, I'm eating a Twizzler.
Well, more tackies for me.
Yep, they're all yours.
Did you have a favorite out of this month's box?
I think my favorite thing were the Pepsi Cola trading cards. Those are awesome.
You learned a little bit. It was an educational box.
Yeah.
Didn't just bring back memories. You learned something today.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to meet all these new future comic stars. Where are they now? I'll have to Google, like.
They all had one comic.
And I'm surprised you didn't pick the Fern Gully trading card.
Well, I liked the Fern Gully ones, but I think we've had them in the past. And the Pepsi ones were all new. And they were pretty cool.
And we have our very own, if we had a vending machine.
I know.
We could put that in the vending machine.
I know. We need to straighten it out and hang it on the wall.
People be like, what the heck is that?
What is that?
I don't know.
Weirdos.
We got it in a Dino Drag box.
Get it? Weirdos. I'm so funny.
If you guys remember any of this or want to tell us what your favorite was, let us know down in the comments. And you can also follow us on Instagram,
Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.